for our annual Night at the Museum event. My name is Jeffrey Bleemeister. I'm the museum's executive director. It's my pleasure to welcome you to tonight's festivities. We have a full agenda of fun automotive things for you tonight. And first on tap is an unveiling of a very special car. Everyone knows a little bit about the Tuckers because they've had a chance to look around here, the Tucker car. We are kind of become the center of the Tucker universe with our three Tuckers. Fourth, if you count the one outside from Howard, we're appreciative of that car as well. We also now have a fifth Tucker in the building. And I'm going to turn it over to Rob Leiter to tell you about this car. The Tucker Torpedo was a concept that never existed, and based on his skill and ingenuity, it's about to come to life. So I'm going to turn it over to me. Please help me welcome Rob Leiter.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you to the AACA Museum for all the support of the Tucker-inspired things that we do in our shop. And we're car builders. We take on a lot of different projects in the shop, but they all have to have some kind of personal meaning for us. We're not really motivated by money. We need these projects to be fueled, but really it's the passion for the cars is what keeps us going. And I think that's probably a pretty common thing for a lot of car people, whether it's your hobby or your business. We really look into the meaning of the cars, and that's what motivates us. So when I'm here in the AACA Museum, I feel like it's become really the home for anything Tucker related. And even this Tucker dealership display, parts of it are inspired by the dealership that my grandfather owned in 1947 for Tucker in New York City. And that is where my family's love for anything Tucker started. It started right then and there, and it's continued. My father is here, Bob Idem. He's a noted race car guy and hot rod guy, and some of the things together. And he remembers when he was 4 years old, being in the back of a Tucker for the unveiling at my grandfather's Tucker dealership. So that's the kind of thing that makes us motivated to work so hard on making these things happen. Sean Tucker, Mike Tucker, John Tucker, great grandsons of Preston Tucker. Ty Tucker is actually the great grandson. And these guys obviously have a love for the car, but it's not just about having the name, it's about doing the work. And Sean Tucker, he spends a lot of his time at our shop contributing his time and his expertise. He's an automotive engineer, and he is a pretty brilliant guy, and I think that comes right from Preston. So he works very, very hard, and he's totally dedicated to doing everything. So what we're about to unveil here tonight is the concept car from George Lawson, designed for Preston Tucker back in 1946. This car is being built for Bob Karakas. He's a collector in New Jersey, who actually is unable to be here tonight due to a family emergency. It's unfortunate that he's not here to enjoy the moment. But we thank him for everything that he does for us, that energy that he puts into keeping this stuff going. So this is a work in progress. This is something that we've been working on for a few years. It's a very challenging project because we're only given a certain amount of information when it comes to making this car. We're not copying the car that's been made before. We're making this for the very first time. And so we don't have the ability to go and measure something else or see how they did it. We are faced with all the same challenges that Preston Tucker was designed for back in 1946 and 1947. So we are rigid in keeping this car looking the way George Lawson and Preston Tucker wanted it to look. So the overall envelope of the car has not been compromised at all. And all of the engineering that goes into it has been worked out so that it can fit within the shape of the car. So I think we can probably start to roll the cover back now. And you're going to see is two sides of the car. One is finished in its body, which is handmade aluminum. Preston Tucker wanted an aluminum car. So if you went to the right side, you can see the body with its skin on, and on the left side of the car, it's more of a skeleton or an x-ray view of what it takes to make a car like this about the Tucker Torpedo, or the Tucker for me, is that it's center drive. So Preston Tucker wanted center drive for a variety of reasons, but he needed to get away from the idea because it's not very practical to get in and out of that car, especially exiting the driver position. Very difficult to get out of it because it is it's kind of a walk from the door open to the driving position. So what we've done as a solution is we've made a rotating floor assembly. So if you notice the entire platform inside the car rotates. You can enter from either side of the car.
Definitely, it's inspired by your fellow. We have a number of other people.